Well, five employees at the El Paso County Sheriff's Office are suing former Sheriff Terry Makita, former Undersheriff Paula Presley, and county commissioners.
The plaintiffs want monetary damages for how they say they were treated during Makita's last term. KRDO News Channel 13's Scott Harrison looked through that suit today. He is live outside the county commissioner's office with new information.
Well, remember we told you that three of the plaintiffs in this case were commanders who were placed on an extended leave by former Sheriff Terry Makita last year. The other two plaintiffs, a sergeant and a lieutenant, who formerly headed the Internal Affairs Unit.
The three commanders, lieutenant and sergeant, filing this federal lawsuit against former Sheriff Makita say the workplace environment was so nasty that former Undersheriff Presley threatened to kill one of the plaintiffs who implicated her in improper behavior, and that Makita didn't care it was Christmas when he considered firing an employee.
El Paso County spokesman Dave Rose says this lawsuit comes as no surprise to El Paso County commissioners, who had been expecting this possibility since last summer. However, commissioners believe it is former Sheriff Makita, not them, nor the county, who should be held liable for anything that the sheriff might have done in office.
The county does not believe that the claims are justified, and the Board of County Commissioners has directed the county attorney's office to defend the taxpayers of El Paso County against those complaints vigorously.
The suit alleges that Makita and Presley violated the plaintiff's free speech rights and retaliated against them for filing a federal workplace report and for supporting new sheriff Bill Elder. Elder declined to be interviewed, but reassured the county that the plaintiffs will try to collect monetary damages from Makita, not from the county itself.
And one of two attorneys representing the plaintiffs in this case issued a statement earlier today basically saying that they want a jury to hear this case, they want the public to know what's going on, and also they want the jury to decide on reasonable damages for the plaintiffs. This is something we'll definitely keep tracking for you. We're live in downtown Colorado Springs. Scott Harrison, KRDO, News Channel 13.